Hey guys, in this video I'm going to do a proof problem from my first semester real analysis class. I think there's actually a couple different ways to solve this problem. I'm going to solve it using the squeeze theorem, and it's a pretty simple proof if you use the squeeze theorem. So before I get into the proof steps, I'm going to go over what the squeeze theorem is. So it says that if you have sequences x of n, a of n, and b of n, such that x of n is less than or equal to b of n, and greater than or equal to a of n, and you know that the limit as n goes to infinity of a of n equals the limit of b of n as n goes to infinity, then you can take the limit of all three sequences to infinity, and let's say this equals to 3, just as an example, then that means you'll have 3 is less than or equal to x of n is less than or equal to 3, which means that x of n has to be equal to 3. So if you plug in a variable or a constant for 3, that basically means that if you squeeze two values in between the x of n and the two values are the same, that means x of n has to be that value. So if you have the same limit for the less than or equal to and the greater than or equal to, that means it has to be equal to. Okay, so using that, we can solve this proof pretty simply. The first thing I would do when looking at this problem, if I didn't have an idea about how I'm going to solve it, is that I would just work on changing what we're given into what we're trying to find. So we know that by assumption, or what we're given, we know that b is greater than a, which is greater than 0. Here, because I already know I'm going to use squeeze theorem, I would go ahead and change it to this, because less than or equal to is less strict than less than, so it always is going to be true if you know that the stricter case is true. And this is going to help me because we have to get it into the form where we can use squeeze theorem. If you didn't know this yet, you could just work on getting it, like I said, to look like this. So if we do that, we know that we have to have a to the n instead of just a. So I'm going to raise to the n for all of these. And in this step, I checked my notes and I checked my answer key. I didn't prove it for my homework when I submitted it, but you could easily prove that this is going to be true if you know that this is true using induction. So I'm going to put proof omitted, use induction. So you know that the base case is true when n is equal to 1 because you have that by assumption. Then if you were going to prove it using induction, you would just say, suppose this statement basically is true, then that would imply that b to the n plus 1 is greater than or equal to a to the n plus 1 is greater than or equal to 0 to the n plus 1. And you can prove that using induction. On my YouTube channel, I think I have a induction video, so you can look that up if you're not sure what I'm talking about, but I'm just going to leave that as proof omitted because that's not the main goal for this problem. If you're doing it as a homework problem, you might want to be thorough and go ahead and prove that this step to that one is correct. So once you have that, you now have a to the n like you wanted. So we're working in the parentheses and we're trying to get out. Next, you see that you have to have the middle term be plus b to the n. So let's go ahead and add b to the n on all three sides. So that's going to be b to the n plus b to the n, which is equal to 2b to the n. That's going to be greater than a to the n plus b to the n, which is greater than or equal to 0 plus b to the n, which is just equal to b to the n. That's going to be, just to clean this up, 2b to the n greater than or equal to a n plus b to the n greater than or equal to b to the n. Next, if we look up again to what we want, we're going to take all of that to the 1 over n. So let's go ahead and do that. So it's going to be 2b to the n 1 over n greater than or equal to a to the n plus b to the n 1 over n, b to the n, 1 over n. If we distribute that, that's going to be 2 to the 1 over n, b to the n times 1 over n is just going to be 1, so we're done on the left-hand side. That's going to be just what I already have. Then we have b. Next, we're going to take a limit on all three values because, again, that's what we're trying to prove, and it should be coming clear at this point that we're going to be able to use squeeze theorem. So let's do the limit of 2 to the 1 over n, b as n goes to infinity. That's just going to equal to b, and the limit of b as n goes to infinity is equal to b, so b is a constant. Thus, when we take the limit, we're going to have the limit of 1 over n, b is equal to b as n goes to infinity, which is less than or equal to the limit as a to the n plus b to the 1 over n as n goes to infinity is less than or equal to limit of b which equals B. I always like to add an extra line that just has a clean version of that, so we're going to see very clearly that the limit of a to the n plus b to the n as n goes to infinity to the 1 over n is stuck between two b's. So now we can conclude using the squeeze theorem. We can conclude that the limit of a to the n plus b to the 1 over n as n goes to infinity is equal to b. And we're done with this proof.